Red Hook, what's your status update? Red Hook?
Red Hook.
Eddie.
Say again, Alex. I mean, Phoenix.
Are you eating?
No.
What's your status update?
Nothing yet.
Service today?
Affirmative.
Wait, what's the code again?
What?
The code, for when I see them.
Sparrow's flying in.
Right, Sparrow's flying in.
Exactly.
No, I mean Sparrow's flying in.
Oh, hi, Stacey. I didn't know you were getting back today.
Did you have a good summer? How's the Gold Coast?
It was okay.
Alex, I mean, Phoenix, did you catch the sparrow?
Sparrow?
Yeah, I was bird watching.
Stacey, come inside.
Coming. I gotta go.
I gotta get going myself, either. Gotta get back too. And she's gone.
You want raspberry twist or orange blast?
I don't care.
Forget about it, man. You don't need no woman. You got me.
I don't know. There's just something about her, like, whenever I see her, I'm like...
Whoa.
Yeah, exactly. It's like...
No, I mean, whoa.
Anything?
Hard to tell.
Let me see. Alex?
Hang on a sec.
Alex? What do you reckon it was? Rocket? Or a missile maybe,
or a meteorite. Can I? Looks like it might have landed just beyond the hill. Imagine if we could see it. For real.
Well, why don't you? I mean, it doesn't look that far, and I'll help you. I got nothing else going on.
I thought you were bird watching.
Bird watching?
We can do that another time. Right, Eddie.
Oh. Bird watching.
So what do you think? You in?
Asteroid collides with a planet, they can create meteoroids that launch out into space. They reckon there are at least like 10,000 other planets with similar mass and atmosphere to Earth. If a meteorite was too... Sorry, I'm rambling.
Oh, I don't mind.
If a meteorite carrying the right microbes landed on any of them, it could create life on that planet. How amazing is that?
Life? Like aliens?
Maybe we're the aliens.
Guys, how much further? Can we take a break?
Dude, it's been hours. Have we come back yet? I'm hungry.
You're literally eating.
And it's cold. Where the hell is she going now?
I'll check it out. Just wait here.
Good idea. Conserve my energy.
We should have reached a landing point by now.
Maybe it landed further up.
No, it was definitely around here somewhere. I'm sure of it. Unless it burnt up on entry. This whole thing's been a waste of time.
Definitely wasn't a waste. I mean, it was nice to hang out with you, and I learned a lot about the stars. And I actually wanted to ask you, Yeah, we're fine.
Where'd you guys go?
Hello? Can you hear me? Red Hawk? Can you hear me?
Alex! Touch it.
What even is it?
You guys making out? You gotta see this. There's a meteor shower.
That ain't no meteor shower.
Why are you covered in goo? Where'd you get a gun? Can I have a go? Maybe later.
The last insurgent who tried to hum his way out of a reed ended up brain dead. So by all means, be my guest. The name. I want the name. Do you know why they call me Reader 8? Because I can get to your most private thought in no more than 8 moves. No matter how hard you concentrate. I heard your brother Thomas was shot dead during the first insurgents. Is that why you joined the resistance? To take down the fascists that put him 6 feet under. But the thing is, your brother's still alive.
Don't tell him where I feel it from. Thomas is dead. Thomas is dead. James.
Sullet. James Sullet. That's his name, right? That's your cell leader?
Fuck you, man.
Your country thanks you for your cooperation.
We have to leave here. Tonight. They're coming with a reader. You know what to do, right? Right? Say, try to hear it up here in your head. That should be enough to keep them out. No matter what, you never let them in.
Freeze, get on the ground! reinforcement has arrived.
There have been droves of terror attacks.
I've suffered millions of casualties.
Americans say enough is enough to terrorist attacks.
Natural-born telepaths have been recruited by the government to increase security.
Readers will be stationed in public places.
Monitoring people's thoughts.
Readers have begun the first round of extraction.
Thousands of insurgents have been extracted and brought to justice.
Readers provide safety for the masses.
We need to protect lives. We need to protect our nation from future attacks.
Californians have safest year on record.
How to fight terrorism while protecting civil
Justice
liberties.
Justice reports find that there are no complaints on the Reader program.
It was announced that the U.S. military has developed a chip to track and monitor natural telepaths known as Readers. This allows the government to collect data on the Readers as well as those around them. The Reader fleet will be fitted with these microchips in the coming weeks.
Lowest crime rates in decades, the economy's booming, but your critics say that the Reader program is created an Orwellian police state. What do you say to that?
You know, Terry, it never ceases to amaze me how short people's memories run. It's almost as if they have an aversion to history. What we have given this country is stability and security.
Yes, but at what price?
To weed out the most corrupting influences of society, I think there's no price that's too high. This is nothing short of
the reservation is for 8:30. Who knows if he'll actually show up?
You have to be within 6 feet of the Reader's chip. It'll take a couple minutes to download everything. And we need it tonight. The window's closing.
Yeah.
Maya, this is bigger than your revenge.
Maya! There are a lot of lives riding on this. Reader 8's chip can give us the entire playbook. You go in, you download, you get the fuck out. Just don't let him read you first. Am I clear? Good. I get clean, you stink.
Please, I swear.
for tears. We don't extract pretty girls like you anyway. Have you ever had a bloody Aztec? Your mother is so serious. Two bloody Aztecs.
So you try to hear it up here in your head. That should be enough to keep them out.
What's a bloody ass?
Find out who the fuck sent her! And fucking kill her! The Boléro, since your daddy sang it to me. Hurry
This is a routine extraction. An insurgent has been identified. Please remain calm. Compliance is necessary.
Started with the small things, the taste of food, the smell of flowers, the purple dog.
I felt her love before she came up.
I just couldn't put my finger on it, but then it hit me.
Hello, is this thing on?
Hello?
Hi, Miss Marley, is it?
Marie.
Hi, Mary. I just wanted to let you know that we are aware of the technical difficulties you've been experiencing. We are on it, and it should all be sorted out in a few days of your human time. Couple of years max.
What?
Meg, are you... Have people in your society accepted the simulation? Shit, 64. I thought, I'm a ghost.
I'm a ghost person.
Shut off, what are the girls?
Sorry, I just, what do we do now? Do we reset her memory?
Yes, no.
Delete her, are you crazy?
Our world is a lie. I'm just a glitch in their system, and all I can do is wait for them to come for me. But do you know what's worse? Amidst all that code, all that alien shit, I was able to make out a name. The universe in which we were born, in which you beat cancer, and where I sometimes can't even face to put on my socks in the morning, is all an untitled simulation. 64!
Well, but nothing's changed, though.
What do you mean?
Sun still goes up in the morning, waffles taste the same, and Birdface Bradley is still a creep. If this is all some kind of a video game, it's a pretty convincing one, even if it has a stupid name.
But it's all a lie!
Maybe if you were religious, but you never believed in anything. All you've done is found proof that there is a creator. You found God.
God is trying to kill me. Oh my God, oh my God, oh my God!
Call psychiatric hospital.
Calling Birdface Bradley.
One, two, Mary Lou.
It's Marie, goddammit!
Sorry. Look, here's the deal. I'm not really a ghost. I'm a researcher, and I'm the head of this whole...
Whatever, man. Just kill me, or delete me, or whatever.
No. We're not gonna do that. Look, these malfunctions, they're gonna be sorted out soon, and I can assure you that you're safe.
I don't care. Life's a joke.
Mary, look, we're simulated too. And I'm pretty sure the ding-dongs who made our simulation are also a simulation. I mean, sure, we created you, but you guys created friggin' Forrest Gump and Muffins and Beethoven's Fifth.
Beethoven created Beethoven's Fifth.
You know what I mean. The circumstances of your existence doesn't matter. I know life must seem strange and ridiculous right now, but I think that was always the case.
Not to criticize your work or anything, but Jesus fucking Christ, man, are you sure you made it scary and confusing enough?
Jeez, I don't... I mean, I could delete you if that's really what you'd prefer.
I guess the shitty stuff is what makes the good stuff so good. I suppose the pain means it all meant something?
Sure. Look, I can't really give you any answers here. All I know is that existence is indeed wackadoo. I think you should relax and enjoy it while it lasts.
Fair enough, alien dude.
You got it, Morgan. Megan, buddy.
What did you mean, while it lasts? Before I die?
Yeah, before you die, before the simulation dies.
What?
Well, we've been having some budget cuts around here, but don't worry, it's not going to affect you guys.
Ah. Cool.
Wait, 64... Oh, shit.
Status is good. John, you were right. This thing can really move.
Roger. You're looking right on the money, Seven.
Roger. My oxygen and fuel are go. Power is go at 2.5 amps.
Roger. Understand.
Power SEP is green.
Roger. Understand.
Yeah. Still reading you. You're breaking up a little bit. Picking up much better on the Bermuda antennas.
Roger. Hold tight. You're about to reach max G's in a few.
Approaching 8 G's. Okay. Okay, we have Seiko. We have capsule SEP. Positive grades fired.
Roger, you look good down here. Infinity 7, tracking says you're go for at least 12 orbits.
Roger that. Turnaround is complete. I got the moon in the middle of my window. It's absolutely incredible.
Roger.
Starting to lose you a little bit. I do not copy, repeat. Do not copy. I'll try to catch you when we're over the Grand Canaries. Grand Canary, Capcom, this is Infinity 7. Read you loud and clear. Switch into fly-by-wire for better control. Hey, Capcom, I got a drop in DC volts and amps. I've got every red light in the world coming on.
Is this just instrumentation, or are we looking at a real problem here?
I don't know, but it looks like I might have a complete loss of Capcom? Capcom, do you read? I think I lost you a little early, switching to UHF to try to get you over Zanzibar. Zanzibar, this is Infinity 7, emergency, do you read? Do you read? Hawaii, do you read? Anybody, do you read? Emergency! Copy on abort. All right, gonna try to aim for the secondary landing zone 6B in the South Pacific, securing abort light. Manual retrograde is armed. Retrograde in 10 seconds. I'm not in agreement with my ASCS. The attitude is all wrong. Switching back to fly-by-wire. Retrograde failed. Retrograde is red. Manually firing retrograde. Retrograde is no go. Retrograde is no go.
Suck out here. Good a place as any, I guess. Thank you.
You do know those biscuits are for kids, right?
Hmm?
Those biscuits you're eating, they're aimed at children.
No, they're not.
There's a cartoon pirate on the front of the packet.
Huh?
For God's sake.
Oh, yeah.
What is that?
What? Whoa! Look at the size of that bad boy.
You know what I think when I see someone driving one of those? Deep down, very unhappy.
RC501, this is RC501.
Oh my God, he's talking to us. Is he?
What?
RC501, this is also RC501. Please respond.
Just drive away. Drive away.
I can't
go.
Drive away, can I?
Accelerate.
I mean, they're right there. Which button is the intercom doodah? Right, okay. This one. Hello?
It's not that one.
Okay, this one. Hello?
Hello?
Actually, I think that's intercom. Hello? Oh, here we go. Hello? Hello? Hello?
RC501, this is RC501. Please acknowledge.
Yeah, hi. Hello. You all right? You all right?
Do you know what? I think one of those buttons you pressed turned on the seat warmer.
Mine's very hot as well.
This is QSKID RC501 of the EESS. Please confirm your tail numbers and skid.
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 Yeah, what's that?
What is that?
Spacecraft identifier.
Oh, the Reg.
The Reg.
Oh, it's CR501.
Say again.
Catheter? Just say catheter.
Catheter. C for catheter.
Okay.
And then it's R. So that's rock. Rock.
Rock.
Five. I mean, just that's just five.
Yep.
Zero, or could be an O for. Oh my God, your brain's gone blank. Orange. And then the number one, so CR501/01. Is that right?
Your skid doesn't correlate with your tail number.
Oh my God. Well, mate, that's the number that's on the front of the big blue folder, and that was in the glove compartment, so.
That may well be, but CR501 is not the number that's painted on the side of your ship.
Do you know what? It's just got scan written all over it.
I'll verify it for you now. Tail numbers, Romeo Charlie 501. That's Romeo Charlie 501.
Well, that's what's written on side of his ship.
Tell him that.
Mate, that's what's written on side of your ship.
I know. That's why I'm here. I am RC501, and yet I keep being pinged for parking violations and airspace infringements that I'm not responsible for.
Stand by. Did you paint CR501 on the side of the ship?
Yes.
Are you absolutely sure that you wrote that on the side of the ship?
Definitely, yes.
Mm.
Yes, I did, yes.
Swear on the dog's life.
I remember it vividly. In fact, it's vivid. I remember it vividly. I did it.
Look at me.
I'm looking at you.
Are you sure you painted CR and not RC?
Well, I'll be honest, this prick's making me doubt myself now. Fuck off.
Base 5 is 9.76 kilometers southwest of your current position.
Okay, plot a route for me.
gravitational waves are currently in Sector 10 and moving northwest at 3 kilometers per hour. You should be in the clear.
Good. Keep me updated. And Mavis, prepare a fresh O2 canister for me, yeah?
Copy that. You need to move now. You have just enough to get back to base. Tonight is the night.
Uncle, what are you doing?
What are you doing?
Mom told me to find you. Is that where you're going?
You see those two stars right there?
Those two?
Yeah. But take your thumb, like that, and line it up with the stars. And that spot, right above your hand, that's where Uncle's going.
I don't see anything. What's that star?
Oh, that one. Maybe you'll go there someday. Come on. How's Pop's mood tonight?
The same. He's a bit happier since Dad showed up.
Of course he is.
Wash him up in.
Hello.
Kiala.
Hey, hi.
Good luck out there, okay? We're really gonna miss you.
Thanks.
Take care of yourself, okay?
Okay.
You're really gonna miss you.
She hasn't let up since grade school.
Yeah, there's nothing she wants at the end of that rainbow.
Be proud of what you've done.
He hasn't been the same since Mom passed. He needed you here.
We've been over this. It wasn't possible. Honestly, it wasn't my decision to make.
Hey, enough excuses. Fix it.
Just a reminder, the last down peg is near the base. Atlas Major sets in less than 6 hours. We need the system up before then.
I know. Or we miss our window.
Oh, that's right. I forgot. You know everything. Not liking that tone.
Your maternal settings need to be turned down.
Sounds like a personal issue. By the way, I tried to review the transport maintenance logs, but I'm blocked out. It's scrambled.
That doesn't make any sense. First the pegs, now this?
Something's not adding up. I'll keep trying.
Look, let's just get through tonight. How much further?
You're close. You'll have a visual of home base and the pit just over this hill.
That's what we're calling it?
Excuse me, everybody. Can we gather around really quick? We're just gonna... No.
Where do you think you're going?
We're gonna toast Kainoa before he leaves us. Kainoa, ever since we were kids, I always knew you were destined to do great things. And we are incredibly proud of you. Mom would be proud. And I'm trying not to think of this as a going away party. You know, 15 years is a long time for someone to be gone. But you've worked so hard. To your journey out there. And your safe return home. I love you, baby brother.
I love you.
To Kainoa.
To Kainoa.
Dad? You maybe want to say a few words?
Warning! Rogue gravitational wave detected. Brace yourself.
I would like to say a few words.
Hey. When I became a member of this family, I've been so stoked to say that my brother is an astronaut. The way things are going, maybe we'll be up there.
I'll check our crate.
Your O2 levels are dropping fast. There's a leak in your intake hose. You need to patch it immediately. You know where the emergency sealant is. Hello? Come in.
Copy. I'm here. Do I have enough to make it back?
Your O2 levels are critical.
But I can still make it back. There's enough time. There has to be something I can do.
I'm so sorry, Kainoa.
Kainoa. He's not entirely wrong, you know. What if something happens while you're out there? What if he's gone before you come back?
Why would he care? Huh? Okay. Why? No, you tell me you saw this. You tell me what you did now.
Stop. You weren't here. I was. While you were at training, I watched cancer take Mom. When Dad fell apart, everything landed on me. You need to make this right. Tonight is your last chance. And you are going to regret this if you don't. Too far out.
Okay. Okay. I'm gonna finish this.
What did Grandma do?
She was a geologist.
Isn't that what Uncle Kainoa does?
Geologists help us to learn more about the Earth, what it's made of, how it's formed. He wanted to be one, just like your grandmother.
Is that why he's going up there? Why are you so mad at him? Didn't Grandma want him to go?
Jada! Hey, Mom wants you. I'm not trying to abandon the family. There's nothing that's going to keep me from going, Dad. But no matter what, I'm still your son. I'm sorry that I wasn't here when Mom died. That I wasn't here to say goodbye. I just wanted you to know that before I leave.
Kainoa. I never wanted you to be anyone but yourself. I just lost your mother. I'm not ready to lose my son too.
Successful chain reaction within the PEG matrix and topographical and subterranean data coming in clear. Connection with Atlas Major established. You did it.
Initiate corporate correspondence transmission. Kainoa Kaleva, Chief Geo Engineer, Phase 5. I am stranded near Sector 1 with a depleted oxygen canister and suit breach. I am unable to make it back to Base 5 after transport malfunctioned. Unable to determine cause due to data corruption. Requesting internal review, over.
I still don't know what caused the energy pack to blow. Everything in the data logs is blocking me out. Shall I keep trying?
No, Mavis. Just file it with corporate.
You know, if I had a physical body, I'd come out there and carry you back to base myself.
Thanks, Mavis. I appreciate that. Mavis, could you record one last transmission for me? Personal.
It would be an honor. Initiating correspondence.
I am Kainoa Kaleva. My sister is Kayala Morris. Her husband, my brother-in-law, is Jacob Morris. My niece is Jada Morris. My mother is Jada Kaleva. And my dad is David Kaleva.
Tell them I said I love them. Tell them I said goodbye.
We did it, Dad. Over.
Relaying transmission now. Received.
Lielius man esat izauguši. Pilna auglības spēka. Vēl mazliet un varēsiet rādīt svorenī visai pasaulē. Cepti. Vārīti. Un citos ārkārtīgi patīkamos veidos. Naktiņu dzimtes kultūra augi. K-A-R-T-U-P. Seši burti.
epidemic. Chernobyl.
Bērzņikungs.
Jā.
Labrīt, Bērzņikungs. Einārs Brakšķis, Latvijas ģeotelpiskās informācijas aģentūra ir izsludināta iedzīvotāja evakuācija. Bez liekas kavēšanās savāciet visu nepieciešamāko.
A, kas tā notic?
Sākšu no sākuma. Nakts vidū jūsu kartupeļu laukā nokrita ģeodēziskais pavadonis. Iespējami ķīmiskā vai pat radiācijas noplūde.
Tu jāglāb kartupeļu?
Kartupeļi? Nav prioritāte, bet ja runa ir par naudu, varbūt varam kaut ko kompensēt. Lūdzu, ģērbi.
Bet tu pat kartupeļu!
Mierīgi, mierīgi. Ja noplūdes nebūs, varēsiet atpirst.
Nu, bet ja būs, bez kartupeļiem es nekur nebraucu.
Mēs jūs varējām aizvest uz Rīgu, izmitināt trīs zvaigžņu viesnīcā.
Tad viņi mani izmet no mājas. Sūds nepavadons. Kā tik cilvēku kosmosa nelien.
Ne. Tas viss vēl var ievilkties. Viņam tur speciālisti jāgaida.
Paldies, nebaidies. Mēs tev ārā nemitīsim.
Es bez kartupeļiem nevaru.
Nu, kas tev ir ar to kartošku?
Es taču neko nevaru iesākt.
Izbeidz, vecī. Neiesāks, neizdarīs. Sakāvnieciska pozīcija.
A, ko? Man taču nekā nav, bet kartupeļu. Viņiem viss ir. Mašīnas, gāzmaskas. Žoks.
Žoks ar signalizāciju.
Ar signalizāciju.
Pistikarī.
Pistikarī.
Jādara kaut kas ir. Zīmējiet tādu bildi. Aldis vairs nekad netiek atpakaļ savā laukā. Kādi varianti?
Nopirksim kartupeļu tirgu.
Es nespēju ēst svešu kartupeļus. Zarnus jau atraduši. Nav tas?
Galīgi nav tas.
Bet es jau par kaut ko citu runāju. Aldis bez saviem kartupeļiem nemaz nav Aldis.
Kā tā?
To tikai viņš pats tev var pastāstīt.
Strādā.
Labdien. Te Aldis Bērziņš. Kad jūs atbrīvosiet manu lauku no saviem krāmiem? Jums ar visu labu. Viņš saprat, ka es neesmu tu.
Un teica, lai tu vēl paciešoties.
Es jau nedēļu ciešos.
Nu, par to jau ir stāsts. Vai tu gribi savu skartpēs atpakaļ?
Jā.
Es arī.
Es arī.
Nu, ko lai mēs darām?
Man ir plāns, kā tika tavā kartupeļu laukā. Saukšu to par operāciju vasaras sēni, piemēram. Latvijas mikologa biedrība saņēma uz ziņas par retām sēņu sugām kaut kur šajā kvadrantā. Pašvaldībā ienāk uz sūdzību par gruntsūdeņas līmeņas svārstībām. Labi, ļoti labi. Mēs tur bildēsim turismu reklāmu.
Jā.
Lūdzu, pasakiet Jurim, lai netērē savu. Un mūsu laiku.
Labi. Bet man kartupeļi jūs solījāt, ka jūs...
Mēģināšu izteikties tik skaidri, cik vien iespējams. Jūs vienošanos parakstījāt.
Nu?
Pārlasiet un nākamreiz sazināsimies, kad es to uzskatīšu par nepieciešamu.
Iedrīt vai noži? Tas paskaties. Iedrīt vai nozīt. Ko es saku? Adrete iemaukuši. Bedri vien palikuši. Vienu ar Lauru un vinēt visu kārtību. Es atceros, kā viņi plātījās, kad to signālu zvaigznēm palaida. Par sakām jau neviens nedomā.
Un parastiem cilvēkiem jācieš. Pajautā, vai man ir plāns?
Sakarīgs.
Operācija ādara.
Solis numur viens. Jā, tiek lejā.
Tā. Aldis, tā ir tava māja. Te ir tava kartupeļa. Pie vārtiem sargi. Pa nakti tikai divi. Juda, tā es tu.
A tu nemok ničo pakrasīvie naiti?
Sēd nost. Un te mēs ar tevi.
Tur tas suns ir aprakts. Nu, vecā baloža, kā viņu...
Šariks.
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 Un šī dāmas un kongi ir ādere.
Šaus.
Nu, beidz. Lai nu kurš ļudačs spēs par sevi parūpēties. Skrienam.
Šeit.
Ja, nekusties. Skaties uz mani.
Es netieku. Kaut kādas saknes.
Kartupeļs te būtu kompliments.
Es palikšu šuheru.
Thank you.
Tu esi tas ķēps, kas man skartu kvizdē savu uzlaidu. Tu zini, ka tevs dēļ mani no mājām izmet. Sēši tagad tas kundziņš kurortā. Kauns ir?
Izskaties, brači. Tas jau tikai kartupurgs. Nakteņu dzimtas kultūra augs. 10 burti. Pagaidu! Es nomežošu. Zvaigšņotais iefiņš. Tev, tu būs sūdi. Jāpirms.
Stāvies cilvēci, bērni vēstures stundās mācīsies, ka Aldis Bērziņš, Ludmila Ozola un Juris Ozols varēja mainīt pasaules vēsturi, nodibināt starpzvaigžņu sakarus, pacelt zināti nākamajā attīstības pakāpē, aizsākt civilizācijas zelta laikmetu, Latviju padarīt par vadošo valsti pasaulē. Bet tā vietā viņi izvēlējās šo. Es jau pašā pirmajā tikšanās reizē teicu jums, Bērziņa kungs, ka jūsu kartupeļi nav prioritāte. Vai tiešām bija tik sarežģīti vienkārši ņemt un paklausīt mani? Ar tām tehnoloģijām, ko mēs būtu iegūši, nu es jūs apvērtu ar tonnām kartupeļu. Nevis šādiem tādiem, bet no tīra zelta. Tie yra zelta. Kāda vēl zelta? Platīna. Bitcoini. Viss būtu iespējams. Vajadzēja tikai mazliet mierīgāk reaģēt, jā? Un ko tagad? Ko tagad? Atkal ar pliku pakaļu rasā. Varbūt varētu kādu maisu no nākamās ražas dabūt.